only a vlog where I want to tell something more the developments in my power supply that I made, and it had to work between say 0 volts and 110 volts DC. There are much more videos about this power supply, how I made it, all the say considerations, etc., etc. But I want to keep this video in a kind of way short and only a vlog to tell about what was made. In an earlier video I made say a kind of circuit with which you can say indicate that a fuse is popped out. And then I mean especially especially on the AC part of the circuit. So that LED that has to indicate that a fuse popped out is here. I also adapted the Hobson Chinese meters. Both of these meters were voltmeters. I adapted that voltmeter to an amperemeter by using a shunt. The shunt is here. And in an earlier video I have published much more about how to make a shunt, but this was the shunt that I finally used. I found kind of deception that this transformer here inside, perhaps it's visible, could only give out say 50 watts or so. But anyway, I used a voltage doubler, that's here. That means that we can take out of such an AC voltage of 39 volts, a DC voltage of approximately 110 volts. Of course, due to say the classical thermodynamic laws and electronic laws and electric laws, that does not mean that you can take more energy out of that transformer that's here, this transformer, you cannot take more energy out when the voltage doubles, the current diminishes. So, one of the classical ideas of conserving energy. I hope I don't have to explain that much better. Anyway, here is that, say, shunt resistor made of steel wire, soft steel wire, that, say, bridges that voltmeter here. It's a 30 volt voltmeter, but of course with this, say, shunt, it acts as an amperemeter. So study, for instance, Ohm's law, etc., etc., to get an idea about how that works. So here we have that amperemeter, here we have that voltmeter, the circuit works to approximately 110 volts, and here the complete overview of the power supply. Ampere can be measured, DC ampere, DC voltage can be measured, the fuse popped or not can be, say, measured. The protection means, in fact, that we shortcut all the protective resistors in the circuit, And in the future, I will surely publish the complete circuit with the, say, transistor regulator. And here the mains fuse, of course, I've used only one switch in the mains. So it could be that when the mains is reversed, there is a high voltage here, even when the circuit is switched off. So anyway, that's why I've made this, say, warning, DC out, etc., etc. Here is the potentiometer that will work in combination with the MOSFET that will, say, govern the output voltage from, say, approximately, not approximately, but 0 volts up to approximately 110 volts. The field effect transistor that I'm going to use has a DC resistance between, say, the drain and the source of 2 ohms. So that means that apart from all the, say, protective resistors here, there will be a voltage drop inside the transistor circuit that I'm going to use to, say, align the voltage between 0 and 110 volts. Anyway, that of course means that the MOSFET that I'm going to use in my first experiment, perhaps it will be not successful, but anyway, in such a case I can use another type of transistor, be it a MOSFET or a bipolar power transistor that can handle, say, 3 ampere at 300 volts, or anyway, in that case, I have to make some adaptations to the circuit. And here you see the switch. To which the whole bunch of protective resistors are mounted. So I can choose with this switch between, say, the lowest resistor that gives out, of course, the maximum current, a somewhat higher resistor in the form of a incandescent lamp, and here are other resistors. I have 5 positions, so, and of course this is also one of the resistors in this unit. It's a simple incandescent lamp made for 230 volts AC, 50 hertz and 60 watts. And I want to refer to the earlier videos where I've talked much more about this. Anyway, that was more or less all to tell. It's only a vlog, so I want to give the definite circuit in the future, say within 2 weeks or so, when everything is worked out. And of course it's more or less impossible to see how all these connections were made with such a bunch of wiring anyway. In fact, the circuit is very, very simple. Extremely simple. And when you look at the earlier videos that I published, you can surely see that the circuit is in its principle very simple. Anyway, going to work further on this power supply. Only thing that I have to make now is the transistor regulator. It will be regulated here. The big knob outside, and here is the potentiometer with which I want to say pinch off and not pinch off, so give more, say, voltage to a power MOSFET. I hope it will succeed. If not, another say circuit will be made with another transistor or another type of transistor, so not a MOSFET but a bipolar transistor, etc., etc. That was all. Thanks for watching.